looking towards the direction of the Statue of Liberty, and something caught my eyes. I dropped the phone, screamed, dove under the desk. And the next thing I heard was this big boom.
After the South Tower was hit, some of the injured huddled in the wreckage of the 78th floor. The fires were spreading. It seemed as if there was no way out.
What we didn't know was a plane, but we didn't see anything. All we saw was an explosion. We saw things flying over the place.
I can tell you the fire started getting very bad. There were beams that were just crashing down from out of the walls.
I watched. I was transfixed. And when the building collapsed, I dropped to my knees and I prayed. I said, "Dear Lord, take me now. Let Welles live."
He could have left, but because of who he was, he chose to stay, and we honor that decision.
What I didn't know was that his spirit was going to carry on in such a powerful way.
And a young man came over and came in screaming and said, "I found the stair, follow me, only help you when you can help." He said it in such a way, we say, "Let's go."
As soon as my wife read this, she said, "This is Welles. They're talking about Welles." I was in the other room. I said, "How do you know?"
They didn't know his name. They didn't know where he came from. But they knew their lives had been saved by the man in the